Hello everyone. So today we will see the preparation of haloalkanes and haloadenes. Preparation, and before that you will see the nature of carbon halogen bond. Okay. So before going into that, some confusion in naming of a compound. Just I will clear it and then move on to the topic. Okay. The compound is 4-tert-butyl-3-iodoheptane. Okay, so this is the compound. So how you name this compound? Okay, so the confusion was in how you write this tertiary butyl. You have to know how you should write the tertiary butyl group. See, tertiary butyl group is nothing but butyl means it must contain 4 carbon atoms, and tert implies what? The carbon atom which is attached to the other carbon atom must be a tertiary, that's all. Okay, so first if the parent name is, parent compound is heptane, so you will have 1 2 3 4 5 and 6 and 7. Okay, now if you number it from this side, you can number it from this side also. So I am going to number from this side 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay. Now it is 3-iodo. So I can write 3rd iodine. It is 3-iodo. And 4th it is tert butyl group. So tert butyl means one is a carbon atom, and the carbon atom which is attached must be a tertiary carbon atom. That is the meaning. See, tertiary carbon atom, and it must contain 4 carbon atom, butyl. Okay, so how is that? This is the tertiary carbon atom, and 1, 2 and 3, the valency. Okay, the valency is 1, 2 and 3. Now, butyl, that means 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, then 3, 6, 9. Butane means C4H10. Butyl means 1 hydrogen is removed and C4H9. So 3, 6 and 9, 4 carbon atom. So it is C4H9. Correct. Tertiary means this carbon atom, the 4th carbon atom is attached to a tertiary carbon atom. So this is tert butyl 3-iodoheptane. Correct. So next, all other valencies should be satisfied. Okay. So this is the compound. Got it? Okay. Now one more compound. Just for the confusion, I will make it clear for you, because so many have asked for it. The compound is 1-bromo. Okay. 1-bromo. 4-secondary butyl. 2-methylpentane. 2-methylpentane. See? How you go for it? 2-methylbenzene. 2-methylbenzene. So the confusion goes in secondary butyl. How you write secondary butyl? Now you know how to write tertiary butyl. That means tertiary carbon atom and butyl group. Now how will you write the secondary butyl group? Okay. We will see. The parent compound is benzene. So you have to first draw the benzene. Okay. Benzene. Now, 1-bromo, if I number, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. First carbon atom, it is bromine. Correct. Now, in the 4th carbon atom is this secondary butyl group. Secondary butyl group is, I think you can't see, no? So I have like this. Okay. This is bromine. Okay. Now we can see. Correct. Okay. This is the 4th carbon atom. 4th is secondary butyl. See? The 4th carbon atom must be attached to a secondary carbon atom, but it must be a butyl group. So definitely secondary means CH. So it must be connected to a CH. Then it contains butyl, 4 carbon atoms. So how will you write 4 carbon atoms? 1, 2, 3 and 4. This also is same. If I write CH3, CH2 and CH3, the same thing. If we put it like this, the same thing. Or the same compound. So this is secondary and this is butyl 1 2 3 4. See, so this is 4 secondary butyl 2 methyl benzene. Okay, so you hope understood how to name the compound. So be very careful while writing the tertiary butyl and the secondary butyl. Okay, clear. Now we will pass on to the next topic, that is nature of this carbon halogen bond. You know, haloalkanes means what? Carbon and a halogen, isn't it? Now what happens to this bond? This bond is partially polar. Why? You know, halogens are electronegative than carbon, isn't it? So what happens? It acquires a delta negative charge, thereby carbon acquires a delta positive charge, isn't it? So this is a partially polar in nature. Okay, then when it comes to halogen, that is fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Fluorine is very small, but as the size increases from fluorine to iodine, what happens to the bond length? The bond length will be greater as the halogen size increases, isn't it? Because iodine is more having size greater than that of bromine, which is still greater than chlorine, which is still greater than fluorine. So CF bond will be very small, whereas CI bond is larger. The bond length is larger. So since the bond length is larger, iodine can be, and that CI bond can be easily broken, isn't it? So the reactivity will be in the order of iodine, more reactive than bromine, more reactive than chlorine, which is still more reactive than fluorine. Okay, so this is the order of reactivity. It's important. Order of reactivity. Why order of reactivity is like this? Since the size of the iodine increases, the bond length increases, thereby the breaking will be easy, thereby the reactivity will be in the order of iodine greater than bromine, greater than chlorine, greater than fluorine. Clear? Okay. Now, next we will come to the preparation. How you prepare haloalkanes as well as haloarenes. Okay, this is very important. Okay, if you are if you are preparing the note of yourself, what you should do, you have to write the preparation in such a way that once by seeing that, you should be able to grasp that. So according to that, you have to write it, the preparation. Okay, first we will see, the first preparation is from alcohols. Okay, we can prepare the haloalkanes or haloarenes from alcohols. Okay, alcohols means what? We have studied ROH. ROH, that is alcohol. The functional group is OH. R can be anything, isn't it? As I said, R can be any alkyl group, methyl, ethyl, propyl, secondary butyl, whatever it be. Okay, so tertiary alcohol can be. So R can be anything, but the OH group must be there. So this is alcohols. So the first preparation is from alcohols. Okay, alcohols. What you should get? You should get our product as RX, isn't it? That is haloalkane, isn't it? Haloalkane. So what happens? This OH must be replaced by what? X. That is a funda, isn't it? So the OH must be replaced by X. So how can we replace this OH from the alcohol by X? Normally, there are three methods from alcohol. Okay. I will write like this. The first method is by treating with concentrated halogen acid. What is it? Concentrated halogen acid. So that I can write it as concentrated halogen acid. Halogen acid means it can be HCl, HBr and HBr and HI. HF normally we won't take it. Like because fluorine is very very reactive, so we won't take consider the fluorine. From HX means HCl, HBr and HF. Okay, so concentrated halogen acid. Okay, next is thionyl chloride. What is it? SOCl2, thionyl chloride. And the third one is phosphorus halides. It can be even PX3 or PX5. See, like this you have to study. first a generic thing you have to know, then you can write the equation as and when it comes. Okay, so there are three types of preparation in alcohol itself. That means alcohols can be converted to haloalkanes by three methods. One is by using concentrated HX. X can be chlorine, bromine normally. Then thionyl chloride. You know thionyl chloride, isn't it? Thionyl chloride. Okay, thionyl chloride. And the third is phosphorus halides. That is PX3 and PX5. The X can be what? Chlorine and bromine. Okay. So by these three methods, you can prepare haloalkanes from alcohols. Okay. Now we will see one by one how you can prepare RX from concentrated HCl. Okay. We will see one by one. Okay. First, we will see how you can prepare haloalkanes from alcohols. Now for that, you put ROH. You want the ROH to be converted. So in this case, if you add concentrated, if you take HCl, normally this reaction with concentrated halogen acid is most suitable for preparing chloroalkanes. Remember, chloroalkanes. Okay. In that case, concentrated hydrochloric acid in presence of, there is a catalyst, zinc chloride as a catalyst. See? Zinc chloride as a catalyst, we will get RX, that is RCl plus H2O. See, simple equation. That is first method by treating this with concentrated halogen acids. And as I told you, this is best prepared for the preparation of chlorides. See, and in chlorides, what you should do? You have to take zinc chloride as a catalyst. And this method, it is not a named reaction, but this is a famous reaction which you call it as Groves process. It is not in the textbook, but in entrance and all it will come. It is called as Groves process. Okay, Groves process, that is the preparation of alkyl chloride in presence of concentrated hydrogen chloride and hydrochloric acid and zinc chloride. This is called as Groves process. And this both concentrated, the mixture of concentrated HCl and zinc chloride is called as Lucas reagent. Just write it down, Lucas reagent. Okay, so many reagents you have to study. One of the reagent, Lucas. So what is Lucas reagent? Lucas reagent is nothing but concentrated HCl and zinc chloride. And this method is best prepared for the preparation of chloroalkanes. And this process is called as, not a named reaction, but still we name it like Groves process. Clear? Okay. Now, in this itself, we can say, if this alcohol is primary and secondary, listen, if this alcohol is primary and secondary, what will happen? You have to treat it with this catalyst, that is zinc chloride catalyst. Why? If this is primary as well as secondary, you treat it with this catalyst. But if this alcohol is a tertiary alcohol, remember, these are the variations in this. Even in one equation, you have so many variations. See? First, if alcohol is there, that is general. Now, in that general also, we have divisions. That is, if it is primary and secondary, you have to have a catalyst. That is this thing. But if it is a tertiary alcohol, you need not need a catalyst. That is it. You need not need a catalyst. This reaction will take place by just shaking these two reagents, that's all. Catalyst is not used. If this is a tertiary catalyst, this just shake it with concentrated HCl, you will get the desired product, that is chloroalkane. So that is simply just shaking at room temperature. Don't even you have to heat it. Here there is a slight heating is necessary, but here tertiary alcohol, no need of heating also. What will happen? Just shaking it with what? Concentrated HCl, you will get RCl. So that is the division in this general alcohol. Primary and secondary, you need a catalyst and just a small heating is required. If a tertiary is there, what happens? There You need not need a catalyst, just you shake it with this concentrate HCl, you will get the chloroalkane. Clear? Okay. Now, what is the role of zinc chloride catalyst here? If a hot question can be asked, what is the role of zinc chloride catalyst? There is a Lucas catalyst, zinc chloride, what is the role? Which means the role is, just the zinc chloride weakens this ROH bond in primary and secondary. Tertiary, it need not be, because tertiary carbocation is highly unstable. It's stable. So, there is no need for here. That is, zinc chloride, the role is to weaken this ROH bond. Just for information. Okay. So, this is the first reaction with the concentrated HCl and the ZnCl2. Okay. Hope you understood. You have to write this equation and study. Just going through the equation doesn't make a sense. You have to get it in your own. So, I always tell you, if you write an organic, if you study organic, just scribble it somewhere. Okay. So, that is the first reaction. Now, the second reaction is with the thionyl chloride, that is SOCl2. And this reaction is of greater importance. Or normally this reaction is used for the preparation of haloalkanes. Board exam question. Why thionyl chloride is preferred for preparing haloalkanes? Now, what is the reason? See, you have ROH plus SOCl2, thionyl chloride, will give you RCl plus HCl plus SO2. See, now what is the peculiarity in this reaction? Once or twice if you write this reaction, it will be memorized, correct? So just write down the equation so many times, so that by seeing itself you can write it. Okay. So ROH plus SOCl2 will give you RCl plus HCl plus SO2. Now, why this reaction with thionyl chloride is preferred? It is because, see, these two products which you are get along with this haloalkanes are gases. See, HCl is a gas in the gaseous form and SO2 is also in the gaseous form. So these two gases are easily escapable, so that the product you get along will be only what? Chloroalkane with no impurities. Still, one person will be, not one person will be there, but still we can say impurities will be much lesser when you compare with the other reactions. Okay, so that is why this is preferred. This is a board exam question. Why thionyl chloride is preferred? Because the other two products which get along with this reaction is escapable gases, thereby you will get pure haloalkane or chloro. In fact, chloroalkane, because you are using thionyl chloride. Clear? Okay, now the third reaction is with phosphorus halides. Okay, phosphorus halides, how will you get with phosphorus halides? The third reaction from alcohol is by phosphorus halides. It can be either PX3 or PX5. Okay, so again ROH plus, if it is a PX3, X can be what? Chlorine or bromine. You will get RX plus H3PO3. See, phosphoric acid. A simple equation. That is ROH, the alcohol, plus PX3, phosphorus trihalide or phosphorus tribromide, you will get RX plus phosphoric acid. Now, what is the difference between when we use PX3 or PX5? For example, PCl5. What is the difference? The difference is in the product, isn't it? Product. What is the product here? See, if it is PCl5, what happens? The product is RCl plus POCl3 plus HCl. See, in all the products, there is Cl here. See, so that is the difference. Here, phosphoric acid directly is formed, but here, the three products, after the three products, everything is having the chlorine. So that is how you remember while writing the product. Okay, so this is another method by phosphorus pentachloride or PX5. X is chlorine as well as bromine. You will get this RCl or RX. Got it? So now it is clear. So this is the three types of reactions where you can prepare haloalkanes from alcohols. Correct? Okay. Now, what about the reactivity? How you will go for the reactivity of these haloalkanes? The same case, HI will be greater than. How is the reactivity? HI haloacids. I'm talking about haloacids. Okay. HI greater than HBr greater than HCl greater than HF. Isn't it? Because of the size of the iodine. Correct. Now, is hope you understood this three first preparation, there are three divisions. Correct. Now, next board exam question. That is, this method from this alcohol, haloarenes cannot be prepared by this method. Haloarenes cannot be prepared from this alcohols, that is phenols. You know, if haloarenes, shall I rub this? Okay. So, haloarenes cannot be prepared from this method. That means haloarenes means what? A benzene ring is there and an X should be there, isn't it? Instead of R, it should be benzene ring. So, when we talk about this haloarenes, this alcohol must be converted to, this alcohol must be changed into X. That is the meaning. But it cannot be done. What is the reason? Or the question may be asked like this. The format is, haloarenes cannot be prepared by this method by using HX and azotan chloride or SOCl2 or whatever be it, or phosphorus halides. What is the reason? The reason is, you know, this is phenol. We'll study second chapter is phenol. This oxygen atom, you know, there are two lone pair of electrons in this oxygen atom, isn't it? Correct. Now, this has got a tendency to form a double bond with this benzene. What is it? This has got a partial double bond character. So, it will be like this. If you want to draw, it will be like this. Partial double bond character. So, the removal of this OH is difficult because double bond means what? The bond is closer. It is very hard. It is very much strength. The bond length is decreased. So, the removal is very, very difficult. Since this oxygen has got a double bond character, rally point, double bond character, the removal of this OH will be very difficult. So, this haloarenes cannot be prepared by this method. So, you understood? There are two questions. Why thiolyl chloride is preferred for this reaction for preparing the chloroalkane? And second is, why haloarenes? Or not like that. They will ask you, why chlorobenzene cannot be prepared from phenol? That's it. A question can be the application question. Why chlorobenzene? They are giving the compound. Instead of haloarenes and alcohols, they are telling you chlorobenzene cannot be prepared by phenol, by this method. Why? So what is the answer? Since this oxygen attached to carbon atom has got a double bond character, which is in resonance, that you will study later, that you don't write. The value point is the partial double bond character. The OH is very much, the removal of OH will be very, very difficult. That is why this is not prepared by this method. So, hope you understood. That is, first three methods. That is, like that you have to write it. In the left side, there are space in your textbook. Okay. So, you have to write there the value points. How it is prepared by three methods. One is concentrated HX. Second is by thiolyl chloride. And third is phosphorus halides. Then you make that concentrated HX again divisions into primary, secondary and tertiary. Isn't it? See how it goes. Correct. Then thiolyl chloride is preferred. You just write in bracket preferred. So then your mind will work. Okay, why it is preferred? Because easily escapable gases. They have the value point. So like that you have to. Then again you can have another point. Like what is Lucas reagent? Then why haloarenes are not preferred. I mean, is not capable of in this reaction. So like this you have to go. Okay. So this is the first reaction, that is from alcohols. Okay.
Now going into the second reaction. Okay, how the second reaction? Second reaction is from hydrocarbon. You know what is hydrocarbon? What is hydrocarbon? Hydrocarbon is carbon and hydrogen, right? Hydrocarbon. Okay. In hydrocarbon, within hydrocarbon, the first reaction is free radical halogenation. What is it? Free radical. What do you mean free radical? Free radical halogenation. Free radical means they are telling the mechanism as free radical mechanism, that's all. Okay, you don't want to study more mechanism. It is the name they have given as free radical halogenation. That means it implies that here the mechanism, the chemistry behind this halogenation is by free radical. Okay, now it is simple. We will see how free radical mechanism or free radical halogenation haloalkanes are obtained. Okay, that is from hydrocarbon. Now, if you take a hydrocarbon, for example, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. This is a hydrocarbon, a simple hydrocarbon, isn't it? What is the name of this hydrocarbon? Tell me. There are 4 carbon atoms and 10 hydrogen atoms. So what is that compound? Butane, isn't it? So when a butane is treated with, now how you halogenate, that is important. Okay, halogenation is done, definitely you want halogen. But here also there is a catalyst, that is UV or HNU, whatever you can. In presence of UV light, when you treat halogen with a hydrocarbon, you will get not one product but many product. That is the, and that is why, since many products are formed, this reaction cannot be used for preparing either one compound. Because in this compound, I mean this reactant will give a mixture of products. For example, if it is chlorine, see, if it is chlorine, you can have CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2Cl. That is the chlorine atom. This hydrogen atom is replaced. Or you can again have what? CH3, CH2, C. This hydrogen atom is replaced. See? Is it? So, isomeric products you will. And that is the one of the reason why this compound, I mean this preparation is not very much useful. But still, you can have this and you can isolate whatever compound is there, you can filter it out. Okay. So this is the second reaction, that is from hydrocarbon. And in the hydrocarbon, the first reaction is free radical halogenation. This is not so important. Why? Because in this reaction, the catalyst used is UV light or HNU, and they will give a number of products depending upon the reactant. If it is butane, it will give 2 products. So, and if you want one of the products in major, you have to isolate it by some other means. Okay, so this is the second reaction. Clear? Okay. Now the third reaction, okay, one by one, we'll go very slow. The third reaction is, electrophilic substitution. What is it? Electrophilic substitution. Very important. Okay. Electrophilic substitution. Okay. Now, you should understand, or when you write or make notes, definitely you will write it as haloarenes. See? The preparation for haloarenes. The other 2 preparation what we studied was the preparation of haloalkanes. This is the preparation of haloarenes. Okay, now we will see how this is prepared. Okay, and that too, this is a subdivision of what? Haloalkanes. I mean, sorry, hydrocarbon. Isn't it? Hydrocarbon, the second preparation. First preparation was free radical halogenation. Second is electrophilic substitution. We will talk more about electrophilic and nucleophilic in this chapter only, but still you make understand. Okay. Now, what is electrophilic substitution? You have a hydrocarbon. That means, arenes means benzene. Okay. Benzene, or you can have a substituted benzene. What do you mean by substituted benzene? Benzene is this. See? Benzene is this. Hydrocarbon means there can be only carbon and hydrogen. Now, if I say substituted hydrocarbon, or substituted benzene, which means that there must be an R group. Okay, and that R group can be methyl, ethyl, propyl, etc. That's it. So I will take an example, CH3. This is called as toluene. Okay, last year you studied toluene. Now I want to make this toluene or benzene to halobenzene, that is chlorobenzene. See, chlorobenzene cannot be prepared from the other methods, that is from alcohol, because of the partial double bond character. But chlorobenzene can be prepared from the electrophilic substitution of what? From hydrocarbon. Okay, benzene. Okay, substituted benzene. Now what is the, definitely what, X2. X2 here is chlorine. If you want bromine, you have to put here bromine. Correct. But this also needs a catalyst. Very, very important. Without a catalyst, the chlorine atom cannot get into a electrophile. Isn't it? Because why? Benzene is a nucleophile. Because benzene is having 3 double bonds. It is rich in electron. So the chlorine atom coming with again a negative charge, isn't it, will get into this benzene only by means of a catalyst, that is any Lewis acid, or I can say iron as a catalyst in dark. Very, very important. Iron in dark or ferric chloride, either of this. Iron in dark or ferric chloride, no, FeCl3. So remember, this equation is very, very important. That is direct this is CH3, and here this hydrogen atom is replaced by chlorine. Very, very sorry. This hydrogen atom is replaced by chlorine. The hydrogen atom is replaced by chlorine. Okay. Now what happens is, here also you will get two products. See, one is CH3 chlorine in the ortho position and other chlorine in the para position. Can you see this? Or I will draw here. Okay, I will draw it here. That is plus again another compound, that is CH3, and here it is Cl. So one is an ortho chloro toluene and second is para chloro toluene. So two products are obtained by the electrophilic substitution. And if you ask me, which is the major product? Because only one will be the major product. Other will be very, very less, minute product. 90% will be what? 90% of the product will be of the para isomer. And only 10% will be of the ortho isomer. See? So, this is the electrophilic substitution for making haloalenes. So, once again I will tell you. If it is benzene, then only one product will be formed. What is it? Only chlorobenzene is formed. There is no ortho or para or bromo, because this any one hydrogen atom gets replaced by chlorine. But any substituted benzene can also be undergo electrophilic substitution. That is why I wrote that. So toluene, on reaction with the halogen in presence of any Lewis acid, for example ferric chloride or iron in dark, very, very important. If you put iron also, the mark will be cut off. You have to say dark. In sunlight it won't happen. Okay, that is a catalyst. Or you put any Lewis acid, that is ferric chloride or aluminium chloride, etc., you will get two products. One is the ortho chloro toluene and the second is the para chloro toluene. You know, right? Ortho and para. Ortho is 1-2 position and para is 1-4 position. And the major product is para. Now, if you ask me why the major product is para and why not ortho, the point is para is having a symmetry. Due to the symmetry of this para position, the major product will be always, when compared with ortho, the para isomer will be the major product due to the symmetry. The value point is symmetry. Para isomers have a symmetry, plane of symmetry. That is why the major component will be, the product will be of the para isobium. So remember, you got it. Okay, so this is electrophilic substitution. Now in this, one more thing here, you add chlorine, right? Chlorine, and you get two products. Now I already told you there are two isomers, para and ortho. We can separate this para and ortho isomer by fractional distillation or distillation. Why? Because they are having very difference in their boiling point. So you can separate this ortho and para isomer due to the difference, high difference in their boiling point. You can separate this ortho as well as the para. Okay, that is again another point. See, in each sentence there is a value point hiding. That is why you have to go thoroughly with each sentence or word by word. Okay, so next is chlorobenzene. You can prepare like this. Well, bromobenzene also you can prepare by this. But if a question is asked, iodobenzene or ortho iodotoluene or whatever substitution, or simply iodobenzene, is this prepared? No. Why? Because see, in iodobenzene, if you prepare iodobenzene, you have to put iodine here, isn't it? You have to put iodine. Listen carefully. Iodine here. Okay. Now what happens? Here, one hydrogen atom is replaced and HI is formed. Okay. So, this iodine is here, and remaining iodine and the H which is replaced will form the product as HI. Isn't it? You got it? Just the reaction. This plus I2 will give you, one I will go here and the other I plus the replaceable hydrogen atom will form HI. But this HI is, this reaction is reversible in nature. See, this reaction is reversible in nature, because once HI is formed, it will come back to this, again to this toluene. So what you should do, you should remove the HI once it gets precipitated or once it gets formed. So you have to do this reaction in presence of an oxidizing agent. See, you have to do this reaction in presence of an oxidizing agent. Why? Because this oxidizing agent, like HNO3 or H3PO4, whatever, this oxidizing agent oxidizes this HI to I2. So then there is no problem. If HI is there, it will reverse the reaction due to Lee-Chadwick's principle. Okay, so our idea, our motto is what? In order to get this iodo form, see, iodo toluene, the product, along with the product HI will be formed. You have to get away with HI by somehow. So what you should do? You should put an oxidizing agent, strong, powerful oxidizing agent like HNO3 or H3PO4, so that this HNO3 will oxidize this HI to I2. So first, when it goes to I2, then no problem, because again I2, the reaction continues in the forward reaction, Lee-Chadwick's principle. Okay, so this is the third reaction. Okay, now the fourth reaction that we will see in the next class, I will just sum up what we studied today, because that is very, very important. Now before I forget, I will say one thing. You have an equation diary, right? You can use either an equation diary or an 80 page, a very small book, for the named reaction, or equation diary is also okay. And in one page, you will have one reaction. What is the named reaction? The name is there. That is, next day we are studying the Sandmeyer's reaction, the scientist put forward by Sandmeyer. So that is named reaction. Sandmeyer, Rosenmans, Fingelsten, Swartz, etc. Wood's reaction you have studied. So like that, named reactions, about 30 or 35 named reactions will be there. So in order to have a collection of this named reaction in one book or in a one lot, either you use the equation diary, because if there is pages, or you will take another 80 page and we will start writing the next class onwards the name reaction one by one, because next class three name reaction will be there. So one page one reaction, I will tell you how to write and then keep it and study in between. Okay, so we will have a recap on this. First is from alcohols. Alcohols by three things. How is it? From halogen acids, then thionyl chloride and phosphorus halides. In halogen acids, by treating with Lucas reagent, that is concentrated hydrochloric acid and zinc chloride, primary and secondary will give you the corresponding chloride, halkanes, haloalkanes, and tertiary, there is no need of zinc chloride, but only by shaking it at the room temperature, you will get the product. Second is, thionyl chloride is preferred because the product you get is two gases which is escaped easily, escapable gases. What are they? Sulfur dioxide and hydrochloric acid. So the formed haloalkanes will be pure, because the other two gases are escaping, right? So only the pure haloalkanes will be left behind. The third is phosphorus halides. And phosphorus halides can be of two types, phosphorus trihalides and phosphorus pentahalide. And one more thing, its phosphorus halides are normally prepared in situ. What is in situ? Then and there. That is red phosphorus with the halogens. You will get that phosphorus halides. Okay. Then the order of reactivity is Ri greater than Rc, RbR greater than RCl greater than Rf. Sorry, Rf. Okay. Then comes the second, that is from hydrocarbon, from free radical halogenation. The halogen plus the catalyst is UV or sunlight. You will get a mixture of compounds, products. The third is electrophilic substitution. In electrophilic substitution, this is the best method to prepare haloarenes. Underline haloarenes. In here, you can use benzene or substituted benzene. If you use substituted benzene, for example, toluene, you have to take that halogen, chlorine or bromine, in presence of a Lewis acid, ferric chloride, or iron in dark. Very, very important. If you write iron alone, you won't get mark. You have to write iron in dark. Only in darkness the reaction occurs. You will get a mixture of two isomers, that is ortho isomer as well as the para isomer, out of which the para isomer is the major product. You can separate these two isomers because they are having a large difference in their boiling point. And the last thing is, you cannot prepare iodine by this method, because by this method, this iodine is reversible, because HI is formed there. According to the Lee Chandler's, it is a reversible process. So in order to avoid this HI, you have to treat this reaction in presence of a very powerful oxidizing agent, that is HNO3 or H3PO4. So that will convert the HI to again I2, making the reaction forward. So these three reactions we have summed up. So I request you all to go through the book thoroughly and write the equations then and there from starting onwards. Thereby you will be very easy. Your organic chemistry will find you very, very easy. So till then, thank you.